What's up, guys? Today, I'm going to talk about two ways to project single images, single cues across multiple laser projectors. A lot of times when we're projecting certain animations, like a lot of text or something, you're gonna get a lot of flicker from the laser, and it may not look very good. So one way to remedy that is to scan those images across multiple projectors and multiple scanners to get a much more solid look. Now, the first way to do that is with the also to function. All right, so as you can see here, I've got two projectors set up, and I have them aligned side by side. And in my zone settings here, you can see I've got them outputting to FB3 controllers, and I renamed them Laser 1 and Laser 2 to make it easy. Projector 3 is going to be my also 2 zone, and I actually just have this outputting to a demo projector, so it's not actually outputting to any laser hardware. So in my also 2 tab, and I'll just show you this real quick, I'm not going to go too far into it because there's actually already a tutorial made about also 2 that's really good that you can watch to learn how to get this set up. But I've got two zones, laser 1 and laser 2, and I've got 50% sending to laser 1 and 50% sending to laser 2. What you really want to make sure you do is just keep everything aligned as best as possible, and that's really going to be done in this tab here, the geometric correction tab. Basically just a lot of resizing and repositioning to make sure that those lines and everything are even. So if I go to laser 1, and I'm just going to select one of these cues here, I'm going to select the city cue. I'm just projecting to that one laser, and you can see that it's getting quite a bit of flicker. This particular cue is pretty heavy on the scanners. I'm using 30K scanners. But yeah, one way to remedy that is to project it across multiple lasers. So the way I do that is I'm going to click on my also 2 zone. And then when I click on the cue again, you can see that that cue is split across laser 1 and laser 2, and I'm getting much less flicker, and the image is just much more clear, and it looks a lot better. So yeah, that's how you're going to set up the also 2. And just real quick, when you're using also 2, let's say I'm going to click on this dinosaur right here. You will probably see where the lines break in the middle of the image where the two projectors are meeting. And depending on what cue you're using or what surface you're projecting onto, this may be a little bit more noticeable. But the best thing to do is just try to keep your alignment as best as possible to reduce that. All right, so this next method is what I like to call the overlapping method. And what that really entails is I've got my two projectors here, laser 1 and laser 2, and I just have them lined up right on top of each other, just overlapping. So again, you're just going to want to try to get everything aligned as best as possible. It's not perfect in this example, I know, but I'm just going to set it up this way just for this tutorial. For the logos that I'm going to be projecting, they're really centered mostly, so the outer edges of the projectors it's not really that big of a deal right here if they're perfect, but I really want to make the center aligned as best as possible. And I'll show you why. So in this method, it's pretty simple. I've got these logos here that I built for a corporate event. And some of these are actually using three projectors, but a few of these are our two projector logos, and I'll use those as the examples. So I'm going to go into my frame editor here, and the way this is done is it's actually just splitting this cue or this frame into two frames. And the way I'm going to do that is, first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to drag this and copy it over here, because I don't want to mess with my original image or my original frame. And so I'm going to go back, I'm going to go to Edit Frames, and all this is really, all you're really doing here is breaking this into two cues. And you're doing this by selecting certain points and deleting them. So as you can see, with these cues here, I went in and basically just deleted certain points and turned that into two cues. So now I'm going to select multi-cue up here. I'm going to select laser one. And that's going to be half of my image. And I'm going to go and select laser two and click on the second half of the image. So now you can see I get my complete logo. And it looks real nice and clear, and there's not a whole lot of flicker. And I'll show you what it's this actually, this cue wasn't too bad on one laser. Yeah, I mean, I'm getting pretty good flicker there. But yeah, so you can see when I project across two, it looks real good. So yeah, that's how I would do that.